everyone. My name is Ranger Maya, and on behalf of the National Park Service, I would like to virtually welcome you all to Dinosaur National Monument. I am here at the Quarry Exhibit Hall, where we have over 1,500 dinosaur fossils on display right in the very hillside that they were discovered in. While the majority of people who visit Dinosaur come for the dinosaurs, there is so much more to do and see within the monument. This 211,000-acre monument is home to some beautiful trails, stunning river canyons, and thousands of years of human history. And we understand that not every person who visits Dinosaur, or would like to visit Dinosaur, has the time to explore some of the more remote areas of the monument or ability to hike some of the trails. This is why we've created this virtual hike, so that you can explore Dinosaur National Monument from the comfort of your own home. Today, we will be hiking the Fossil Discovery Trail. This mile and a quarter trail connects the Quarry Visitor Center and the Quarry Exhibit Hall. Today, we'll be hiking downhill, starting from the Exhibit Hall and ending up down at the Visitor Center. Along the way, we'll travel through millions of years of geologic history and stop to learn more about the ancient landscapes that existed here millions of years ago, as well as the sorts of life that they supported. Standing here at the start of the trail, we can look out into this landscape and see an array of different rock colors, ranging from light yellows and whites to darker grays and reds. And all of these rock layers have also been tilted upright in a formation called an anticline. They were once horizontal rock layers, but have since been uplifted and folded, creating vertical aisles of different rock. And over time, erosion has chipped away the top of that anticline, exposing all of those rock layers that were once buried underneath. Today, we'll be walking through some of the younger rock layers that make up the south side of the Split Mountain Anticline. We have made it to our first spur trail. We'll be taking a left here to head into the Jurassic era about 160 million years ago. The first stop on our hike takes us to about 161 to 156 million years ago, when this area was covered by an inland sea. Around us are the pale beige walls of the Stump Formation. Inside this formation, we find all sorts of evidence of marine life. Fossils of small creatures like belemnites, ammonites, and snails, along with bones of larger marine reptiles like ichthyosaurs, have all been found in this rock layer. Taking a look at this rock right next to me, we can see thousands of small indentations and bumps. These are the impressions of saltwater clams. The next stop on our hike is here at the Morrison Formation about 150 million years ago. Most of the Morrison Formation is composed of a gray, red, or purple clay or mudstone. But this area that we are stopping at follows a gray sandstone cliff that is made up of river-deposited sand and gravel. Because of the age of these rocks and the type of environment that existed here, this rock layer is an ideal location to find dinosaur fossils. Along this sandstone cliff, we can find fragments of dinosaur bones and more impressions of freshwater clams. This cliff follows the same sandstone layer as the Quarry Exhibit Hall, but paleontologists haven't worked on this wall to expose any of the bones. So keep an eye out for anything that's discolored, shiny, or orange found in the cliff. More than 10 different dinosaur species have been found within the Morrison Formation in the monument. These dinosaurs range from massive 90-foot sauropods to tiny 7-inch lizards. While these massive dinosaur fossils are super interesting, it's actually the smaller species that give scientists the most information about the environment that these animals lived in. Research on fossils of smaller animals, plant remains, pollen, and insect trackways have all been used to decipher what this landscape was like 150 million years ago.
Based on that research, scientists believe that this area was semi-arid and warm, with year-round streams and small rivers very similar to the modern-day Serengeti. Ferns, conifers, ginkgo trees, and horsetail rushes would have scattered the area. As we continue down the trail, we'll be leaving the Jurassic period and entering the Cretaceous period, the third and final period of the Age of the Dinosaurs. We'll know when we get to the Cretaceous era when we see the Cedar Mountain Formation, which is very similar in appearance to the Morrison Formation with bands of grays and purples. In the Cedar Mountain Formation, researchers from Brigham Young University discovered four skulls of a long-necked sauropod dinosaur called Abetosaurus mcintoshi, proving that there is still so much more for us to discover within the monument. Our next stop will take us into the silver-gray mounds called the Mowry Shale, which is dated to be about 99 million years old. At the time, volcanoes along the coast of an ancient sea near the present-day California-Nevada border spewed ash, which fell into the salt water, killing most of the fish swimming there. Currents at the bottom of the sea then scattered their scales. And if we take a closer look at this shale, we can see tiny, almost shiny, gray to golden fish scales fossilized in these rocks. The last stop on our hike will bring us to a time that hits a little closer to home. Petroglyphs and pictographs left by the Fremont culture about 1,000 years ago are a reminder that people have been calling this place home for centuries. While little evidence has been left of their presence, an impressive array of petroglyphs or carvings in rock and pictographs or paintings have been discovered all over the monument. The style and content of designs varies across the region, but there are a few commonalities amongst most Fremont petroglyphs. Human figures have trapezoidal bodies, which may or may not include arms, legs, hands, and feet. Some figures have elaborate decorations like headdresses, earrings, and jewelry. Animal figures found include bighorn sheep, lizards, birds, and snakes. We can speak with descendants of the Fremont from modern Native American groups about what these petroglyphs may mean. But for now, they provide an intriguing connection to the people and the cultures of the past. The last leg of our hike will take us along these sandstone cliffs. As we walk along, notice the ripples in the stone. These were made back when this area was a sandy shoreline along the coast of an inland sea. So we have made it back down here to the visitor center, and we hope that you all enjoyed learning more about the ancient landscapes that once covered this area, as well as the types of life that those landscapes supported. And hopefully through this, you've been able to see just how much dinosaur has changed over time. And the monument is continuing to change, even today. Every day, weather, gravity, and even we as people are causing changes to occur on this landscape. So as you go off and enjoy the rest of your day, take a look around you. Think about what this landscape is going to look like 10, 15, 100 years from now. And think about the impact that you want to have on that change. Thank you all so much for joining us on our hike down the Fossil Discovery Trail today. If you're interested to learn more about Dinosaur National Monument, or if you're looking to plan your next trip here, you can go ahead and visit our website, www.nps.gov/dino, or feel free to follow us on social media as well. Thank you again. Look forward to seeing you around here soon.